This video will show you how to back up your Moodle content by downloading your Moodle courses and uploading them into your Google Drive. As you know, KVCC has switched its LMS platform from Moodle to Canvas. KVCC is decommissioning Moodle. Once this happens, you will no longer have access to any of your content in Moodle. Because of this decommissioning, it's important that you back up any Moodle content that you could possibly need access to in the future. Backing up your Moodle courses ensures that you can still access content if the need arises after Moodle is decommissioned. We ask that if there's even a remote possibility that you will need to access something you have on Moodle in the near or distant future, that you back up that content as soon as possible. One important thing to note before we get started is the file type you'll be downloading. We're going to be generating a .mbz file, which is a Moodle course backup file type. The .mbz file will have all of the information about the class you choose to back up, including different pages, documents, and even the structure of the course. The only thing it doesn't include is student information. Downloading the entire course this way simplifies the process and ensures that nothing is being left behind on Moodle where it won't be accessible. However, .mbz files are meant to be read by an LMS like Moodle or Canvas, not by a computer, so they can't be opened on our computer or on Google Drive. I have this sandwich diagram to explain it. Moodle can take the .mbz file and turn it into a full sandwich. It understands that everything is there, in the right spot, and can read it in an easy-to-understand package. Moodle can read the .mbz file as a sandwich. However, we wouldn't be able to open that .mbz file on our desktop or on Google Drive. It's like this middle picture. All of the parts of the course are still there and they're saved in the file, but they aren't put together in a way that our computer can read, and we can't open that file. The computer and Google Drive can't read the .mbz file as a sandwich. It's just a stored collection of sandwich parts that aren't put together and can't be opened. To open the information or to access parts of the course that are saved in the file, we have to upload it into our new LMS, which is Canvas. Canvas can read the .mbz file like Moodle did, and will put it all back together in order for us like the last sandwich. Just don't be surprised when you try to open the .mbz file in Google Drive and it doesn't open. It's not supposed to be opened without an LMS. And I'll have another video that shows you how to upload your .mbz files from your Google Drive and into Canvas. It's very easy and I'll walk you through it, so don't worry about that at this point. Before we get started, we want to make sure it's perfectly clear that if you do not back up your Moodle content, you will not be able to access it once Moodle is decommissioned, and that the FSC will not be able to retrieve your content in Moodle once it is decommissioned. If you don't have it saved, you will not have access to it. To get started, you'll need to log into your Moodle account. You can do this by typing moodle.kvcc.edu into the address bar of your browser. Next, click Login in the top right corner. Log in with your KVCC information. Once you're logged into Moodle, find the navigation block on the left-hand side. Locate the My Courses tab and click the arrow to expand it. This will make a list of all of your courses that you have in Moodle. Locate the course that you would like to back up and click it. Once you're in the course that you would like to back up, find the administration panel on the left-hand side and click Backup. Once you do this, it will open to the Backup Settings page. We're not going to mess with any of these settings. Everything that we need click is already done, so we're going to click Next at the bottom. Because Moodle will be inaccessible when it's decommissioned, we're going to download the entire course so we don't miss anything we need later. It's much better to back up more than we need than to miss something. So on this page, we're not going to mess with any of these boxes on the left. We're going to leave those all alone to make sure that everything gets downloaded. Can scroll all the way down, and it may take a while if you have a lot of content in your course. If you don't have a lot of content, you won't do as much scrolling. When you get to the bottom, click Next. So once this page opens, we can see that we're on the third step. It says confirmation and review at the top. When we get to this page, we need to decide on a file name for your course that you're backing up. And we want our file name to be something descriptive so that when we see the name later, we'll know exactly what we're looking at. So for this, I'm going to name it Humanities101-GEV, because that's the name of my course. I'm also going to include Moodle Backup in the name so I know what this course is exactly in terms of that humanities course. Then we also have to keep this .mbz at the end. That's the file type. If you get rid of the .mbz, it won't accept it as a name. So here is my descriptive name, Humanities101-GEV Moodle Backup.mbz, and that tells me exactly what this is. Once I'm happy with my file name, I'm going to scroll down again past all of this stuff, and at the bottom, you're going to click Perform Backup. At this point, it could take anywhere from a few seconds to a few hours to back up your course. It depends on how large your course file is. Unfortunately, you can only have one backup running at a time, so you'll have to be patient at this point. Once you get to this page, it says complete. We know that our course backup is ready for us to download, so we're going to click continue. And this is our backup page. We're going to scroll down to this user private backup area. This is where all of our course backups will appear. And you can see that the name that I gave mine appears right there, the Humanities101-GEV Moodle Backup.mbz. That is the one that I just did. So it's backed up, but we haven't downloaded it yet. It is still stuck in Moodle at this point. So to get it actually onto your computer, we have to click download. So your Moodle class backup file is now saved onto your computer. It's in your downloads file, but that's not where we're going to leave it. For this, we're asking that you put it into your Google Drive. Now, there are a couple of different reasons why we're asking you to put it here. First of all, Google Drive is a cloud storage system, which means instead of saving the file onto your computer specifically, it's saving it to remote computers somewhere else. There are a couple of reasons why this is good for us. One is that you can access this data anywhere you have internet access. It doesn't matter if you're at home or if you're visiting Italy or if you're on your computer at school. If you have internet access and your login credentials, you can access these files on your Google Drive. Second, let's say that you had saved this on a flash drive or it was saved on your computer and you misplaced that flash drive or your computer crashes. Those files are now lost. That won't happen if your information is saved in Google Drive. Because it's saved somewhere else and it's in the cloud, it will be there even if you misplace or something happens to your technology where you're at. And finally, it won't take up space on your computer. The more space you take up on your computer, the slower it runs, so this will just keep things going a little bit more smoothly. So whether you know it or not, every employee at KVCC has an employee Google Drive. And to get to it, you need to log into your My Valley account. Here's mine. And if you scroll down on the left under employee links, it says employee Google Drive. You're going to click on that. Here is my Google Drive. You can see I have some different files. I also have some folders down here. Now, before I put this in my Google Drive, I'm going to make a folder for it so that anything I download off of Moodle, I can put into this folder and find it really easily in the future. So to do that, I'm going to go up and click this plus new, and I'm going to click the plus folder. It's the very first one. Just like naming our file, we want to give this folder a good descriptive name that will help me know what exactly is in it. So I'm going to call this folder Moodle Backup Data. And you can see it just made that new folder for me. It's the one highlighted in blue. And I'm going to be putting all of my Moodle backup documents into this folder. So to do that, I'm going to click that folder. So now that I'm in my Moodle Backup Data folder inside of my Google Drive, we're going to take that file from our downloads and upload it here. The way we're going to do that is we're going to click the plus new up at the top here. And instead of making a new folder this time, we're going to go down to File Upload. This means that we're taking a file off of our computer and putting it into our Google Drive. And where this opens up kind of depends on where you were last at in your computer. You can see that I have a bunch of random files here. That's not what I'm looking for. I'm looking for my downloads because that's where it saved when I took it off of Moodle. And I know this is the right file that I'm looking for right at the top because it has that name that I gave it. Humanities101/DEV/MoodleBackup.mbz. That is my Moodle backup that I just performed. If you just did your download, it should be at the very top. If you wait a couple days, you may have to scroll down a bit and find it. You can also type the file name in here if you need to find it. Another reason why it's important that we give it a good name. So I'm going to click the file that I want to put into my Google Drive and click open. And you can see down here in the right-hand corner, it's showing me how it's going. And when it's finished, there it is, shows up in my Moodle backup data folder inside of my Google Drive. If you have more than one Moodle course that you would like to back up, you'll just go back and repeat this process again, going back into Moodle, performing the backup, saving the file, and then uploading it into your Google Drive folder that you've made. So now you know how to back up your Moodle courses and how to put them in your Google Drive. You are all set for our Moodle decommissioning. Make sure that you take all of the Moodle backups that you need because it will be inaccessible and you won't be able to get them once Moodle is decommissioned. It's really important that if there's even a slight chance that you may need something in the future, that you back it up to your Google Drive because we won't be able to get it once Moodle is decommissioned. Of course, if you have any questions or you need help with this, contact the FSC and we are happy to help.